Hi, welcome to my channel. I'm Allison. I'm a wedding photographer. Cat mom, dog mom, goat mom. I think I have more children. Nope, that's it. Wait, we just got a ferret. Well, okay, let me just tell you. We didn't buy a ferret. A ferret wandered into my parents' yard and started licking my dad's toe, and it was almost dead. So we rescued a ferret. I'm not sure how long we're gonna have this ferret because she stinks to high heaven. But for now, she's really cute. I need to share photos and videos of her because she's so cute. But she's hairless because she has adrenal issues. Anyway, we're off on a tangent here. I'm Allison. I have a lot of fur children. I'm a wife. I'm a Target lover. I got this from Target. And I'm a photography educator, just helping my fellow photographers hit their six-figure goals and go full-time. So if that sounds like something you want to do, be sure to like, subscribe, hit the bell so you get notifications. Okay, today we are talking about discounts and when to give them, when not to give them, if you should give them, or other options other than discounts that you can do. So you gotta be really careful with discounts because you'll end up attracting a garage sale bride who like thinks you're a garage sale and can just talk you down $1,000, $2,000. If you think about it, Louis Vuitton, I'm not sure they've ever had a sale, and there's a purse I want there, and I already told myself I'm not getting that purse until this happens. I haven't told myself, oh, I'm gonna wait till Black Friday when it's on sale, because it's not gonna be on sale. So we wanna have like a Louis Vuitton mindset, not even Walmart does discounts. Do you know what I mean? And it's Walmart. But there are a few exceptions to the rule, and I have given discounts before, and here is what I do and the requirements I have for discounts versus maybe a free item or something like that. So for discounts, money, monetary value, there are four discount rules, I guess you could say, I have for my business. One, if the wedding is at a venue that I am dreaming about and I want to shoot so bad, I would literally shoot it for free. I don't shoot it for free, but that is one time I will give a discount because I want to shoot that venue. Number two, if it's my downtime, typically my wedding season is March through June and September, mid-September through December. If I have a bride inquiring for July and it's a slow season for me, I might give a discount. Or if I have January, February, those months also, which I'm more likely to give a discount because it's winter. In Texas, it's 75 degrees, but in the summer, it is 100 plus with humidity. So it's not like I'm dying to get outside and shoot a full wedding for a discount. Do you know what I mean? Number three, if you want to work with specific vendors, mainly if I am dying to work with a specific planner, or if I know that this bride has an amazing planner and amazing florals and good taste, all that, I'm more open to giving a discount to fit their budget. Four, if I know the couple and I really want to work with them because I know they're amazing and they're so sweet and I've already shot their friend's wedding, I am open to giving a discount. Number five, I actually have five. This is a bonus. If I do an open house and it is huge, or maybe a bridal fair. I haven't done a bridal fair, but if I did do a bridal fair, I would do a discount. I would do a discount that day. I would say today only, you save this much money. But then I will extend it a few days because it's really hard to get somebody to book that day. And I only have it open for so long because that increases the urgency and it actually makes people want to book. You don't want to just give a discount and like have it open for who knows how long. The whole reason of me giving a discount at a bridal fair or an open house is to book them that week and get them in the door booked. That is the reason for the discount. It's not just like, oh, here's a discount. It's to increase urgency. Now let's talk about how much to discount. My most popular packages are $4,800 and $6,200, and I have never discounted above $500. I don't do a percentage just because my highest package is like $14,000. So, can't even do the math, but $500, a set number is a good idea. So maybe do 10% of your lowest package and then have that set number as a discount. So say your lowest package is $2,000, then have your discount be $200 for any package. You also don't want to just give out discounts like they're going out of style, or tell them upfront, like, hey, I'm gonna give you a discount. Because a lot of your couples will appreciate the value of what you're doing. If somebody asks me for a discount, I usually get weirded out. It's kind of offensive to me. Hey, can I get a discount? Just because they don't appreciate it. When I give a discount, it's usually me following up with them. And then they're like, oh, I'm so sorry, you're out of budget for us. And that is when I come in and I'm like, oh, what is your budget? I can work with you. I don't always do that, but if it's one of my four things, like they have a really great planner, or they're at this amazing venue that I love, or I know I'm gonna get amazing portfolio work out of it, or I just love the couple, or if it is the middle of February and I know I'm bored out of my mind, those are times when I definitely am willing to work with couples. But if I have a couple getting married in October and I already have 6 October weddings, it's highly unlikely that I'm gonna give anyone a discount unless Taylor Swift literally calls me up and she's like, hey girl, I'm getting married and I need you at my wedding to photograph it. But then again, Taylor Swift would not, she appreciates value. She would never ask me for a discount. Plus she's like a multimillionaire, maybe a billionaire, I don't even know. Just saying. It would literally take Taylor Swift for me to give a discount in October. On the other hand, if you don't want to give a discount, say you want to do a Black Friday special and you don't want to come across as the garage sale photographer, you can offer a free item when somebody books you this week of Black Friday. This is what I've done. I have offered a 10x10 album for anyone who books me from this day to this day. And it has actually worked quite well. You just want to be careful not to undervalue what you're doing by discounting everything. If you're just starting out, I would discount as much as you need. Or if you just moved, or if you had a baby and you fell off the face of the photography earth for a couple of years and now you're back and like nobody remembers you. That's why I'm scared to have children. Those are all times when it is definitely acceptable to give discounts. So there you have it, discounts. If you have any questions, comment below or message me on Instagram. I ask my followers a lot about what videos they want to see, and a lot of voting happens. So if you don't follow me already, go do that now. I'll see you next time. This is what it's like living on a mini farm. Just want y'all to know. I'm gonna tell you a little story. We were not supposed to have a rooster when we got chickens. We had 7 chickens. They were all supposed to be females, okay? One. We had one rooster come out of that. His name was Ethel because he was supposed to be a female. So Ethel made some babies and we hatched some babies, and then we had Ethel Jr. And then Ethel Jr. ended up killing his father, Ethel Sr. So Ethel Jr. became the rooster. Ethel Jr. had babies, and one of them was a male. So then he became Ethel Jr. Jr. So at some point, Ethel Jr., the first, died, like randomly. I didn't realize chickens like don't last very long. Anyway, he died, and now we have Ethel Jr. Jr., who will not shut up. I think it's because his name's Ethel Jr. Jr. Anyway, feel free to browse my videos here and click on my face if you haven't already to subscribe, and I'll see y'all next week.